Mike Cockrell.
Richard Landry.
What's going on, Mike? How you doing, brother?
Me and Richard, you know, we go pretty far back now. We competed against each other on Master Distillers, and we both from the Deep South. We're good friends.
What in the hell are you doing up this way?
Man, I'm just riding. I love this beautiful scenery. Look where y'all at, man.
We're in a beautiful place, right?
Look at that. I don't never get to see nothing like that in life.
So you just out on a damn joyride.
That's all I'm doing, man.
I like going out on road trips and stuff, but I ain't never found my way to Louisiana.
Well, I mean, Mike told me he took a road trip from Mississippi. I mean, he wound up here in the mountains.
I live here, though. I've been here for 15 years. You know what I mean? Richard lives in Louisiana, and the price of gas is through the roof right now. I mean, that's a long down way just to be out joyriding.
Look, I got something real good. You know about that Hmong VAT. You from the 1 mile marker.
Yeah.
Let me let you taste something.
Let's do it.
This is a Hmong VAT corn that we did. Aged it a little bit.
Looks good.
Tastes pretty good, too.
Well, it smells good, buddy.
That's a good barrel it come out of.
I have to give you props. That's some good tasting liquor there, Landry. Is it selling good, or?
I cannot make enough of this stuff. But you know what? I'll be honest with you guys, man. I'm just sick of dealing with that bayou water. I'm in an area of the world where I got a truck water into me, man. This limestone water y'all got down here, man, is something totally different.
We got the best water.
Y'all think this liquor is good? I can make it better if I had water like you guys got here.
You wanting to set up shop around here?
I don't want to step on y'all toes. I'm just trying to make myself better.
Richard's got his game on, and he thinks he can up his game by coming here and finding better water.
You know, you can't just roll in somewhere and just automatically just set up camp. I mean, who are you working with? Where are you going to be doing this?
You got to know somebody.
I'm still working on all that right now.
You need something, you're more than welcome to holler at us. We'll do everything in the world we can to help you. You know what I mean?
All right.
I don't know what the hell Richard wants here.
Y'all take care.
All right, man.
All right, it's good seeing y'all.
But whatever he's doing here, he's got me worried. That Mongolay tea, it's good stuff.
And having good water, you may make it better.
As bad as I friggin' hate to say it, we've got competition. We've got to up our damn game right now. We got to up the game.
Hey, look. I got us an ace in the hole. I got us somebody who I think is going to be able to help us, and he'll take care of things. I'll get him to come by, let you meet him, see what you think about him.
Well, I've been with you long enough. I trust you.
We got this, man. Don't worry about it. What's up, buddy?
What's going on, brother? How y'all doing?
We're doing pretty good about yourself.
We're doing real good. So you got something good?
We have here some Mimosa Moonshine. Take a sip of it and see what you think. Tell us what you think about it.
I tell you what, that's pretty good right there, bro. You said you had 5 gallons of it, huh?
Got 5 gallons of it.
Believe me, everybody get a little sip of that.
Yes, sir. Got it?
I tell you what, fellas, there's gonna be plenty of happy people when I get back to town.
You're pretty tickled with the way it turned out.
I've been trying something kind of like this already before.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, something kind of like what?
I only called it like Moscow tea or Moscow tea or something.
Mongolay?
That kind of sounds like it.
Hmm. Where'd you score that at?
Well, my buddies, it ain't far.
You know, there's one person we know that's got some kind of drink like this. That's Richard Landry with his Mongolay tea. You know, this tells me and Mike that, you know, Richard is serious.
It ain't gonna happen, I can tell you that right down now, son.
Now, Mongolay tea, we know where the hell that came from.
Richard Landry.
We're not even starting our season now. My buyer's already got his hands on that. I mean...
Well, he's trying to step on our toes, what he's doing.
But how does he know where our toes are? That's what I'm trying to figure
out. He's moved into our damn territory. He's slipping around. He knows the people that we're selling to, and I think he's trying to, you know, gather them for himself. If I've got to go by the Moonshiner's code, so does he.
Yep.
If he knows that's our customer,
and continues to sell,
mm-hmm.
That's a problem.
Gonna be about it.
I beg him.
I'll blow his to kingdom damn come.
Well, let's roll that cord just yet. Mm-hmm. Dude, look at that. That's Richard Landry right there.
There's our truck.
I mean, we don't want to get right on top of him, so let's pull over right here.
Coming around the curve up here by the little park where Richard and Craig was eating last week.
Both there again.
Obviously, this is a normal hangout spot. I'm gonna get out, but you keep your eyes on them too. If they turn over toward that way, you blow the horn and get back to the truck.
Okay. How you feel?
Got it on there. Let's get the hell out of here.
All right. Now this bush is behind us, so he'll never spot us.
Easy. Yeah.
Oh, they never even turned around.
Boy, duck that.
Hell yeah.
Shit. I'm gonna catch that ass red-handed, baby.
Catch him with our hands in the pot for real,
hell
huh?
Hell yeah. Let's go to
an out.
Oh, yeah. There we are.
Oh, okay.
Right there at that blue dot. And when he starts moving, there'll be a set of eyes pop up.
Oh.
It's traveling. Okay. See, there's the tables.
Damn accurate, ain't it?
Yeah, real damn accurate. Mission accomplished. We got these guys. We can track them from now on. We now wait for them to leave.
Okay.
And follow them where they go. Oh, hell. Here goes nothing.
Where in the hell are they?
Well, I'll tell you what, son. They picked a damn hell of a spot, didn't they?
Hell, I reckon.
Yeah, there's
a
creek.
There's a lot of water right there.
So they gotta be in here close.
God almighty. Hey, Jerry, smell that? Smell it?
Smells like something fermenting to me.
It's fruit.
Told you we was getting close.
We smell mash.
That's exactly what that is.
Watch strong. Look, yonder, Jerry. Look.
Look.
There it is right there, baby. That some bitch is right there. First damn time in my life I've seen a camouflage tarp stick out like a sore thumb. See if they're running.
Oh my God.
It's a lot bigger than I thought it was gonna be. These guys got 150 gallon pots sitting here, man. These guys is upscaling in a hurry to try to cut our throats, and me and Jerry's got to do something. Check this out. Them. That's pawpaw mash, man. One of my biggest recipes.
Oh my God.
Sit there and copycat somebody else's damn recipes and then turn around selling to our customers.
What are you gonna do about it?
Hey, man. Why the steel uncovered?
What the?
Oh, man. Come on, man.
Oh,
no. Oh, man, our mash.
What the hell happened here?
Look at this.
So we get to the steel site, come around the corner, and all the barrels are toppled over. There's mess everywhere in the steel site.
Oh, everything is just messed up here. What the hell happened here?
I'll tell you what happened. The bears happened.
All three of our mash barrels are laying on their sides. There's scratch marks, claw marks, bite marks. This is no good for us.
Thing was trying to get in here, man. Look at that. I didn't think these bears would be able to get into these barrels. We don't have bears in Louisiana. I don't see anything like that, but these barrels are scratched to high heaven, and they're just all bit into. This one's full. He didn't get in this one.
Full?
Look at this, man. Man, this is a bear, man. Man, this was supposed to be our big money maker right here. This was supposed to be our huge run. I mean, we got another massive setback.
This is not a good day.
This one's full.
Ooh, full. Some good pawpaw wine.
Yeah. We're gonna take all that mash and put it in that pot, Craig. What we got left here, we ain't got enough to do with, but at least we can make a little bit money, man.
Our steel is still here. It's intact, mainly. We have a few dents in it, but it's nothing that we can't fix. We're gonna be able to run what we have left.